Now, earlier we have seen the centrifugal compressors. Now we are going to go for axial compressors. So earlier I introduced what are axial compressors and how do they look like. Now I'll go to some more details to give you an introduction. So for an axial compressor, we have a series of blades on shaft. At least once we should have one stator and one rotor blade. The stator blades are the stationary blades and the rotor blades are the blades which will keep moving, that they will rotate. So we have alternate rotor and stator blades inside our axial compressor, and the rotor blades are mounted on shaft. So shaft is a rotating element. That shaft is rotated using some external mechanism. We may have an engine, we may have a turbine, we may have some motor, etc. And since it is rotating from energy which is cutting from somewhere outside, the rotor is moving and that fluid is passing through the rotor. So as the rotor moves, the rotor is going to impart kinetic energy to that fluid. So the velocity of the fluid increases when it passes through the rotor. And stator is mounted on a casing. So we have already earlier seen that there are three important parts. Casing was one of them in any fluid machine. So casing is a stationary part, it will not move. And the stator is mounted on the casing. So stator is also not going to move. So what's the purpose of stator? It will convert kinetic energy to the pressure energy. So earlier also we had this idea that we have some section, the impeller in centrifugal compressor also, we had impeller blades and then we had diffuser. So diffuser is very similar to stator, and the impeller are very same to rotor. So the one of the section is going to increase the energy. If there is an increase in energy in terms of static pressure, there is no need of the stator or a stationary equipment such as diffuser. But if we are going to increase the kinetic energy or dynamic head, then another equipment should be used. It's advised to use a diffuser or the stator over here. That stator is going to convert that extra kinetic energy which the fluid has to the pressure. So at the end, we have all gain in pressure energy itself and we are not having any kinetic energy gain. So whatever initial kinetic energy was there, we'll have the same kinetic energy at the end. And now let's see what are the different types of rotor. So there are two main types of rotors or centrifugal compressors in large. First is the drum type. The drum type, the main differences will be this. The drum type has the solid shaft, that is the main difference. And since it is having a solid shaft, which is shown over here in blue pen, the blue ink shows the solid shaft over here. And since it is solid, it's going to have a larger weight. And hence it is generally used in stationary or ground applications. And the casing outside, which is the stationary part, this is the casing which is sewn in black ink. And the blades over here in black are stator, and the ones which are sewn in blue are the rotor blades. Okay. And we must see that we want to keep the velocity constant, the flow velocity, which is in the direction of the diffuser or the compressor. That flow velocity should remain constant. We are not talking about the absolute velocity or radial velocity. The axial velocity or the flow velocity, both are same, that should remain constant. So we want flow velocity to remain constant. When we write mass flow rate equation, m dot is equal to rho av, we want flow velocity to be constant. So we want to compress the fluid and we can reduce the area, increase the density of the fluid such that the mass flow rate remains constant. That's the first and all whole and solve requirement of any fluid machine. The mass flow rate must remain constant. The second type is holotype. That's the main difference between disc and drum type. So the holotype means it is going to have less weight and it's hence it is more applicable to aircraft engines. We can see the central part, the rotor is hollow and we have put some fins on it. Those are the rotor blades, but inside structure also over here, we can have, let me show. over here inside structure also we can have some fins type of structure or any kind of arrangement that will give the strength to my the rotors. The shaft will get some strength, so we can have some arrangement, but these are not important things to discuss. Now the first set of blades is always stator blades, and their function is to guide the smooth entry, guide the fluid, incoming fluid, for smooth entry on the rotor blades. So they give or they direct the fluid entering towards rotor blade for a smooth entry. These words are very important. So they are not of converging cross section. The first set of stator blade are not of converging cross section. We'll see the other stator blades are actually of converging cross section. So they will decrease the area, hence increase the pressure. And they do not convert kinetic energy to pressure energy. They are just to, their just objective is to guide the fluid, and hence they are also called as inlet guide vanes, or generally we can also say guide vanes. But for inlet guide vanes, we will say them as inlet guide vanes. Now, and they also do not do any diffusing action. Generally, stator blades are for diffusing action. But the first set of stator blades, which are called as inlet guide vanes, do not perform any diffusing action. And now coming to rotor, rotor imparts kinetic energy, hence it will increase the velocity of the fluid. And rotor, then next are stator blades. So after a rotor blade, we'll again have a stator blade. And these stator blades act as diffuser as well as guide vanes. So here the stator blades perform both action. They'll guide the fluid and they'll diffuse the fluid. So they'll diffuse the kinetic energy gained during the rotor blades to pressure energy. So stator, first set of stator blade, they are this. So whatever stator blades which are coming after the first rotor blade, they are called as the stator's first set. So we are ignoring the first stator blade, which are inlet guide vanes, and then a rotor blade and a next set of stator blade makes one set. So their job will be to decrease the velocity, that is the diffusing action, and increase pressure that comes under diffusing action, and they guide, so they'll change the direction. So there are three purposes for them, while the inlet guide vanes are only one purpose, they change the direction. And one thing, one set of stator and rotor blade, one combination of stator and rotor blade are called as one stage of compressor. So we can put multiple alternate stator and rotor blades, and then we can increase the number of stages of compression. But you must remember the first set of blades should be inlet guide vanes or stator blades. And the last set of blades must also be stator blades. So at the end, we have maximum pressure rise and least velocity gain. In the next video, we'll see about velocity triangles.